like books that are about reading? Do you like books that are about books? Do you like books that are historical fictions? Are you looking for a book that is based in the World War II era? If the answer to any of these questions is yes, then my friends, you've come to the right video. Hey guys, I am Sankalpita and you're watching BookGeeks India, which is a channel where I make book related videos. If you like books, if you love reading, make sure you're subscribed to my channel, like and share my videos, turn that notification on. And guys, please do comment because you know it that I love it when you comment. In this video, I bring to you a book review of a book that I think should be read by every book lover. It is a book about books, it is about reading, it is about World War II and the aftermath of war, and it is also historical fiction, something that I absolutely love. So this book is called The Guernsey Literary and Potato Peel Pie Society by authors Mary Ann Schaffer and Annie Barrows. So I saw this book first on Instagram and I also saw it on Goodreads, and later when I saw it as a movie on Netflix, I was like, yes, I have to go and buy this book right away. So I decided to read the book first and then watch the movie, but I just couldn't control myself and I just went ahead and watched the movie while I was only 20% in the book. I'm just glad that I did both because now I can compare both, and in the end, I would definitely say that the book is much better. Expect a book that talks about books and reading. Also expect a book that is set in the aftermath of the World War II, and expect a book that talks about the German occupation of this small English island called Guernsey. Also expect a book that talks about innocence and love and beauty. Coming to the story of this book, so this book tells us the story of this author called Juliet Ashton, who used to write a lot of humorous books during the war years. So during the war years, Juliet Ashton was full of hope and she used to find humor so that she could entertain the masses who were otherwise very sad and full of despair. But now that the war is over and people are picking up the bits and pieces of their life and, you know, trying to put together a life after the war, while people all around her are hopeful, she is kind of losing all hope. She's sinking into depression because in this war she also lost a lot and she just cannot put a price to how much she lost. So she is looking for an inspiration to write her book, but she's also suffering from writer's block. This, combined with the fact that she's in not a good state of mind, kind of spells doom for her. But all of that changes when one day there arrives a letter from a guy called Dorsey Adams, who lives in this remote English island called Guernsey, and he asks her about certain things, basically about books. And soon they start conversing and Juliet gets to know that there is this peculiarly titled society called the Guernsey Literary and Potato Peel Pie Society, which was, you know, established in Guernsey during the years of the German occupation. So how this society came into existence, it is a very interesting story and a very interesting name also, which you will have to read about when you read this book. But sooner, Juliet starts interacting with all the members of the society. This heralds the start of a beautiful friendship between Juliet and the members of this society. So much so is their love for each other that Juliet ends up being in Guernsey to see and meet these people. And it is there, when she reaches there, that her life and the lives of all the members of the society changes forever. This is a book, like I told you, though it is set in dreadful times, it is still full of all good things about life, about love, about reading, about books. And there's so much of love, passion, positivity and hope that is there in this book. Since the book is written in a very easy language and it's a short read, interesting read also, it can be picked up by beginner level readers. But let me just tell you that the book does slow down in between, so make your choice accordingly. Coming to the characters of this book, I think all the characters in this book are worth looking forward to. They are mostly the goody ones, the innocent ones. Sometimes it's really difficult to believe that how can all the characters be so good. So mostly when you come across good characters or well-built characters, they have different shades of grey in them. So they are good, they are bad, and they are somewhere in between. But when you come to this book, all the characters in this book, well, most of the important characters in this book are all the goody-goody ones. writing style of this book. So the author writes in a way, in a format which is called epistolary format. Now this is a format which makes use of letters to tell the story. So basically the entire story of this book is told in the form of letters, which Dorsey writes to Juliet, Juliet writes to Dorsey, Juliet writes to other people write back to her, and so on and so forth. So the entire story of this book is told in the form of letters, and that is something which will be good for you as a reader, because obviously you read something new, you read something different, and that is good for you as a reader. I think the climax was a bit random. It was also abrupt. It could have been better, but in the end it did give a befitting end to the story. So I found it okay, not too good and not too bad either. What I loved the most about this book is that this book talks to us in such a beautiful way about books and about book lovers, about readers and about reading. So you come across so many things that you can relate to as a reader. Like when Juliet talks about books and her love for books, and Dorsey also talks about books. So you can relate to those things on an entirely different level. It's like the author is speaking for you. You are there and you're talking about books. It is so good. And then there are some beautiful quotes about books, about reading, which are an added bonus. When it comes to entertainment, the book moves at a good pace. It has a really different premise. So there's a lot of drama. Of course, there are books and reading. Then there is the German occupation, and then there's also the aftermath of the World War II. All of this put together make the book a really interesting read. Something that, you know, I gave 4.5 stars to, because I absolutely loved reading it. I will give you 4 reasons to pick this book up. If you're looking for a different kind of read, like a book written in a different format, like I told you, in the epistolary format, if you like, you know, historical fictions, historical dramas, if you also like books about World War II or books set in the World War II era, and finally, if you like books which are about books and reading. If you don't like books that somehow slow down in pace towards the middle. This book is not a fast-paced read, and that is probably one reason why you would not want to read it. And that is the only reason I would give you if you want to skip this book. So that's it from me in this video, guys. Thank you so much for watching this video. Do let me know in the comment section below if you enjoyed this video. If you enjoyed this video, please don't forget to hit that like. Also subscribe to my channel if you haven't already. And until the next video, which will be pretty soon. Bye.